The decade that is coming to a close is possibly the most significant for the Indian two-wheeler industry. From Indian manufacturers finally launching products which are truly global and world-class, the decade also marked a significant milestone with the Indian two-wheeler industry dislodging China to become the world's largest two-wheeler market by volume. As the year and the decade comes to a close, we take a look at the most significant two-wheelers which were introduced between 2010 and 2019. The Hero Maestro was launched in 2012 and became the first scooter from India's leading two-wheeler manufacturer, Hero Motor Corp, after it parted ways with Honda to set up independent operations. By 2017, the second generation model called the Maestro Edge became Hero's largest selling scooter. Today, it still ranks as Hero's most popular scooter and is available in two engine options, 110cc as well as 125cc model. When India's TVS Motor Company introduced its flagship 125cc scooter, the N-Torque 125, in early 2018, it broke new ground in the Indian scooter segment. With first-in-class features like Bluetooth connectivity, turn-by-turn navigation on a full digital instrument console, and a smooth and powerful 3-valve engine, the TVS N-Torque 125 changed the way 125cc scooters are looked at in India. Today, it's one of the best all-round scooters available on sale and will probably go down as one of the game-changers in the scooter market. Suzuki Motorcycle India may not have the volumes to compete with two-wheeler market leaders like Hero, Honda, TVS and Bajaj. But where Suzuki scores big time is in well-rounded products. And some of these became hot favorites in their segment over the past decade. With decent fuel economy for a 125cc engine, smooth and refined performance, as well as very good road manners, the Suzuki Axis 125 cemented its place as India's highest selling 125cc scooter. If scooters are considered utilitarian, the Aprilia SR150 broke new ground as the most performance-oriented scooter of the decade. With 14-inch wheels, taut handling and thrilling performance, the SR150, with its sleek and modern design, with bright paint scheme, truly defined the term sporty scooter. It may not be utility-oriented and has its share of cons, but as a scooter, which offers pure excitement, even with its modest performance, it's still right up there and makes it to this list purely as an enthusiast scooter. Honda Motorcycle and Scooter India is best known for the ubiquitous Activa scooter, India's most popular scooter for decades now. But when Honda's entry-level sport touring motorcycle, the Honda CBR250R, was launched in 2011, it started a new generation of motorcycle touring fans. With its smooth engine, decent cruising ability, and bulletproof reliability, the CBR250R still has a strong fan following, even though it has been replaced in several global markets by the slightly bigger CBR300R. The Honda CBR250R to this day is considered a benchmark in the entry-level sport touring category in India. When Bajaj-owned Austrian motorcycle brand KTM made its India debut in 2012, it marked a significant chapter in Indian motorcycling history. Ever since the Yamaha RD350 from the 1980s, no other motorcycle boasted of the performance the 390 Duke offered, at a price which still makes the 390 Duke best bang for your buck. Although it's a street motorcycle, the touring crowd also lapped up the 390 Duke, and even today the 390 Duke, with its sharp handling and explosive performance, makes for the best budget performance motorcycle available on sale. KTM's parent company Bajaj Auto also decided to milk the 390 Duke's popularity with its own model, focusing on a model that was designed to make motorcycle touring affordable. The Bajaj Domina took birth in 2016 as a park cruiser, but more importantly, it promised the versatility of a daily commuter with the performance and capability to go long distance touring, all at a significant price advantage. Although the Bajaj Domina came with a slightly different state of tune on the 373cc engine shared with the 390 Duke, today the Domina is still one of the most popular touring motorcycles in India. If motorcycle touring came of age in the last decade, Hero MotoCorp treaded new ground in 2011 with the Impulse, a purpose-built off-road oriented 150cc motorcycle, which is considered a path-breaking entry-level dual-sport motorcycle. Although the Impulse failed to set the sales chart on fire and was discontinued in 2016, Hero followed up with a slightly more powerful X-Pulse, which was first showcased in 2018, followed by its commercial launch in 2019. The X-Pulse, with a 200cc engine and decent off-road capability, has captured the attention of thousands of adventure and off-road enthusiasts in India, looking for a dual-sport motorcycle at a budget. But Hero isn't the only manufacturer dabbling in purpose-built off-road-oriented adventure bikes. Royal Enfield, which pioneered motorcycle touring in India, launched the brand's first adventure bike in 2016. The Himalayan, with long travel suspension, high ground clearance, and a new 411cc engine, had its shares of niggles, but today, it's still one of the more common entry-level adventure bikes seen on Indian highways and in the high mountains. The Himalayan has managed to establish its own set of ardent fans. If premium commuter motorcycles focus on fuel economy and decent performance, the Suzuki Gixxer set a new benchmark in the 150 to 160cc motorcycle segment in the last decade, a segment largely dominated by the Bajaj Pulsar and to some extent the Yamaha FZ series. The Gixxer brought in a combination of engine refinement, handling and fuel economy that set a new benchmark in the segment when it was first launched in 2014. The Yamaha YZF R3, popularly known as just the R3, is the first Yamaha motorcycle with a parallel twin engine to be introduced in India, after the two-stroke RD350 of the 1980s. Sporty performance, great design, and a price tag of under 4 lakh for a parallel twin sport motorcycle, the R3 was a great all-round product. But despite it being an excellent motorcycle, it didn't quite become a commercial success. Nevertheless, it makes it to the decade's significant motorcycle launches for good reason. BMW Motorrad introduced the brand's entry-level motorcycles, the BMW G310R and the BMW G310 GS in 2018. These two models, the most affordable BMW motorcycles, have a very important India connection, because they have been manufactured in India at the TVS Motor Company's facility in Hosur, Tamil Nadu. The joint collaboration of TVS and BMW was agreed to develop their new engine as a common platform. And even though the BMWs aren't exactly affordable, they have certainly managed to establish India as a manufacturer of quality two-wheelers on the global map. TVS Motor Company, meanwhile, introduced the company's own version of the common platform with BMW. The Apache RR310 became the flagship motorcycle of the Indian two-wheeler manufacturer and the first full-fed entry-level sport motorcycle under the Apache brand. The RR310 has gone on to receive rave reviews and a steady fan following, and is right now one of the best entry-level sport tourers available on sale in India. Royal Enfield may have been slowly and gradually updating its motorcycle range over the past decade with minor incremental technological updates to its range of single-cylinder engines. But the introduction of the new 650 twin platform catapulted Royal Enfield's ambitions to establish the brand as a global leader in the mid-size motorcycle segment. The 650 twins, the Interceptor 650 and the Continental GT 650 offered a level of finesse, refinement and performance never before seen on any Royal Enfield ever. Today, these two models have single-handedly helped Royal Enfield strengthen its global footprint and expansion plans to establish Royal Enfield as a world-class motorcycle brand. Harley-Davidson's first all-new model in 13 years is the Street 750, a model manufactured in India for the local markets, as well as for many global markets. The Street 750 cemented its position as the brand's highest-selling model in no time. Even today, the entry-level Harley-Davidson Street series is the brand's highest-selling motorcycle and comprises 80% of the Harley-Davidson India's sales numbers. The Made in India Street series made an aspirational brand like Harley-Davidson affordable, and the volumes make it one of the most important Harley models of all time. Ducati revived its Scrambler brand in 2015 with the Italian brand's modern classic style motorcycle, with styling inspired by the original Ducati Scrambler of the 1960s and 70s. The new Scrambler brand not only fueled a completely new range of hipster customers, but also offered an entry point into the Italian brand as the most affordable Ducati models. With the Scramblers available in several new retro flavors, the Ducati Scrambler is certainly one of the most popular motorcycle brand revival stories of the decade. The Triumph Tiger 800 made its India debut in 2013, although the first Tiger 800 was introduced in Europe in 2010. In its third generation now, the Triumph Tiger 800 middleweight adventure bike became a roaring success in India, with its off-road capability as well as a refined and sporty performance from the inline 3-cylinder engine. Even today, it's the highest-selling midweight adventure bike in India and has a massive fan following and demand even in the used bike market. In 2017, Triumph Motorcycles updated the Street Triple with an all-new 765cc inline 3-cylinder engine. With feisty performance and sharp handling, the new Street Triple RS set a new benchmark in the naked street motorcycle segment. In 2019, the Street Triple RS got one more update with minor cosmetic changes as well as new engine internals worked on by Triumph's Moto2 engineering team. Now, there's an updated gearbox, a new exhaust cam, new intake duct, lighter crank and clutch, as well as a freer flowing exhaust. The result is an even more engaging mid-range performance and razor-sharp handling. The Street Triple RS remains one of our favorite middleweight nakeds till date. As far as adventure bikes are concerned, there's no other adventure bike as the well-known or as aspirational as the BMW R1250 GS, the big GS. A replacement for the BMW R1200 GS, the 2019 R1250 GS introduced several technological innovations, including a new shift cam variable valve timing system on the new engine and a long list of electronic rider aids. It's not difficult to understand why the big GS has been so popular worldwide over several generations, and in India too. It is the most aspirational adventure bike right now. In fact, many current owners of the GS have graduated from middleweight adventure bikes like the Tiger 800 and the Africa Twin.